And what we can, what we're gonna do is, I'm sorry. There you go, sorry. I did it after you said I wanted it, so, you want your own? Okay. If I have to keep one, yes, I do, there you go.
Pretty good, bigger.
Well, hey, you know.
No complaints, it's me and that.
It is what it is.
Yeah, it's great, very great.
So am I. Okay, so the target of tonight's meeting is to review what we have already on the CIP project by department, and then talk a little bit about it, because I'm sure a lot of you aren't prepared yet of what you propose putting on going forward, if there's things that you want to add to the CIP for your departments, okay? Or rearranging the priorities within your department as well. We can do that as well, so that's what tonight's business is about, okay? I'm gonna bypass general government, and I will start with the police department.
All right, lucky me. For those that don't know, we've had some cruiser issues over the last 2 months, mainly because of the mileage in the vehicles. And one of the options that we're going to explore with the district board is to maybe consider next year leasing two vehicles, get rid of two vehicles, so we can bring the mileage down. But right now, other than one of the vehicles, everything is well over 100,000 miles, and they no longer run the warranty and whatnot. So assuming that we do that, how do we change that for 2019? Because I'm assuming if the select board decides to go with that, for 2019, I would think that instead of 25,000, the initial payment would be 30,000, and then 20 and 20 for 2020 and 2021. So.
Because it's two.
Correct.
Okay.
So you're looking at $60,000 over 3 years.
Okay. So and 19 would be 30?
Correct.
Okay. 20 would be 20, and then 21 would be 20.
Correct.
Okay.
Can I ask the term of the leases that you're contemplating on these cruisers?
These are just rough figures at this point. I have not contacted leasing companies. I won't do that until such time we actually sit down and negotiate with the select board at this point. But generally, when you're getting a government lease, they're fairly reasonable. And you know, in the lease, like we did in the past, you pay a buck and the vehicle's yours. So essentially, what you do, it's not like a lease that you and I would have for our personal customers. It's really just a financing program.
Extend the life of your vehicles you're going to own, which is the payment basis. But I know we talked about the possibility of leasing, because I know we set this up with the every other year, the 25,
correct, yeah,
and regular repeated purchases. And I know at that time we talked about the leasing options then too. And obviously on a shorter alert lease term that, you know, we're going to go over a mileage anyway, so we'll take the hit there.
Mileage is not a concern, because the ultimate goal is, as long as the townsfolk say, you know, vote on, yes, we will lease the vehicles for 3 years and then they become ours, the mileage isn't an issue. Not on the government.
Because you're buying it.
You
don't have to
correct.
Pay the miles.
Correct. And if we get to right away, then that's necessarily going to significantly reduce the mileage issues that we're having with the older stock, with the older stock right now.
But can you refresh my memory as to why we discussed this in previous? We talked about this before. You didn't like the idea.
Well, I liked it.
Now, however, a year ago.
Right.
A couple years
right.
ago.
Yeah. However, the folks did not want to have to pay the fund use charge. So, and that was it, as opposed to buying outright. Correct. Yeah.
I don't understand. I'm sorry, refresh me.
They didn't want to pay the interest over 3 years for the, you know, it's like, you know, like when you buy a car, you get it through a bank. You're paying so much per month or per year for the interest.
Okay.
So.
But it didn't have anything to do with having something and obligating money for 3 years. So, you know, in advance, it didn't have anything to do with that. I thought it, at one time it did, that we couldn't commit money beyond
I've heard both sides of that equation.
Yeah.
But from what I understand, especially that budget thing that we had here a couple months ago on the training,
mm-hmm.
that
mm-hmm.
you could do that as long as at the beginning, the first first time you vote, that people are aware of the fact, this is gonna cost you X amount of dollars.
Yep.
For this year, and this year.
Yep, and this is your interest, and this is your payment for the month.
Correct.
And I think you're right, but I thought that was at one time the issue, but many departments lease.
Many do, yes, yeah.
So it can't be.
And we actually did that in 2005, we leased two vehicles in 1 year in 2005, two Chevys actually. And it did well for us until, you know, for that one time, but then we get back, because again, we had an older fleet issue, and in order to get the mileage down, the cars that are being used every day, that's why we leased at that point. But after that, the select board said, well, you know, it's, now that the mileage is down again, you know, we don't wanna pay the finance charge, so just every other year, we'll purchase a vehicle for you folks.
I guess I'd be interested, and like you said, you haven't heard from the leasing companies, and you're.
I haven't contacted them, because this is something that we're just now beginning to discuss. I think it was 2 or 3 weeks ago, I approached the select board about considering maybe doing that for next year.
But you did the '05 deal, so you've been through.
Right, we've done an '05.
Yeah, I'd just like to hear more when you get closer.
So like I say, once you negotiate with the select board, then you can bring more detail to CIP and which direction you're gonna go. But we all have noted that that's possibly a proposal here, so, and I'll have them modify that. Okay, so what about your radar message board?
We're still hoping for that for 2019.
Okay.
And again, we have applied for a grant from the state, and we should know by August whether or not we've been approved. So once we start really getting into the budget process, we'll know right ahead if we have that grant or not.
Okay.
And I know the last time we talked about the digital fingerprinting system for the PD to replace the current one that we have. There was some discussion that maybe we should try to get it if and when the new building is built. For those of you know, we're still trying to go forward with that proposal. If that's the case, then that might be placed into that package. If that does happen in 2019 or 2020, then certainly, you know, that $20,000 can come out of 2021.
Okay. Let's go back to government administration, because that is where this facility is showing. And the dollar amount under gross capital cost is way off. Yes?
Let's see, where are you now? Police administration?
4 line down, up in government, town administration, police facility.
555,000.
Yeah.
Well, I guess, what is the town's plan for that particular line item? Is that for a new police station by the town hall, fire station in the future, or is that for ongoing repairs for this building? The reason I say that is we all know that the furnace needs to be replaced here. We got notification this week that the generator is gonna need about $2,200 in maintenance repairs, and the generator is no longer, the parts are no longer available from China for that particular unit, it's just outdated. We had two HVAC condensers fail on us 2 weeks ago. When they looked at the HVAC condensers, they said every single one of them should replace because of their age. We have two of them where the cement base is beginning to rot away on them now. And remember back in 2017, I requested $20,000 to upgrade the security system. At a town meeting, I asked just to give me the $10,000 because we were hoping to go with the new police facility in 2018. That didn't happen, so you know, depending on what happens with the new police facility, at some point we need to put the upgrade for, if we stay here, then we need to really consider the second half of that plan to upgrade the security system in the building. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's hard to be issue for these. I mean, that sounds like something that isn't going to be back burner things. We talk about the generator. I know it's a lot of money, but it has to be there turnkey, ready to go.
Correct. So at some point, these four items need to be placed back on this. So
within the next 5 years.
Well, maybe even sooner, possibly.
Okay, that's what.
Yeah. So I guess my question to the CIP panel here is, what is the intent for that line item for town administration police facility?
And my thought was that it was for the new one, not the renovation. That was my understanding when we were working on this last year. What did you guys think?
What was your realistic number that you had in your mind when you saw that happening?
Well, we know what it is. It's a million.
It's gonna be.
Yeah, 555,000 is not a new police station or administration building.
No, but
it's not a police station.
But I don't know if we had the numbers when we were doing this.
Well, we didn't.
Right, so that was probably a guesstimate, which.
If the plan is, if the policy put that towards the new facility, whether it's police in town or police in fire, you know, I had proposed in the past when we went to these meetings, fine, we have some money set aside each year for the police facility.
Mm-hmm.
Use that money possibly towards the bond and or interest
mm-hmm.
over the next 20 years, 25 years, 30 years, whatever the town decides to do for the bond issue.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, you might possibly hit, you know, if the CIP panelist said, yeah, let's use that for that, you can really do that. I'm not sure if you can or not. But at least here you have money set aside, so you could say, all right, assuming we're in 2019, starting 2020, there's at least $70,000 right there that you could put towards the first year's bond
mm-hmm.
and or interest.
Mm-hmm.
And so on. Just to give you folks some history, back in 1998, I think it was, the town set aside $50,000 per year, 1998, for renovation of this building. $50,000 was set aside for the principal, and then it started, I think it was $32,000 the first year for interest, and then for the next 17 years, it, you know, worked its way down. So the town has set aside a significant amount of money in the past for a major project.
I'm looking at 105 available right now.
That's what's in CIP right now.
Right, and I know we'll be added to it over the years, but the biggest question still needs to be answered about new versus renovation.
Right, and so the police study committee has met, and Bob has been given some direction as in to also obtain numbers for town administration as a top floor and the police on the bottom floor, just to give options to the town. The previous one was submitted was only a bottom floor of just a police station. So if we're going to do it, and that's what the wishes of the town is, we should just do it all at once. Just with it. So he's going to have two different proposals. He's going to have one just for the police station, and then one for prison town administration. The question is, what do you do with this? That's the biggest question. That's what people are going to want to know. You know, what are you going to do with this building? And also, is having police leaving this building, then you only have half a dozen people in here, which is, you know, you still have to keep the whole floor and, you know, and
you can't say enough pros for getting a new police. You can't say enough cons against getting a new police station. I mean, it really needs to be. I mean, we've just wrung every bit.
I agree.
And unfortunately, the value that remains is,
correct.
You know, I mean, how long did Blue sit empty before anyone even
mm-hmm.
looked at that?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a big building, but what do you do with it? It'd be nice to make some revenue off it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, ideally, the only thing you probably really do with this building is find a developer that will take it on your hands. They're not going to come and buy it for $100,000 or $1 million. They'll come and give you a buck for it. But at least they will spend the money
yes.
to properly renovate it and then put it back on the tax.
So then you're going to get taxes.
Sorry, you're going to get taxes.
So you're
going to
get some down the road.
Absolutely.
You know, we actually had a developer interested in this building back when we did the renovation. But he came in and said that, I'll take it out of your hands for $1 and I'll spend millions of dollars to fix it up. And I think at that time they were going to put apartments in here. I think it was 5 or 6 apartments. But the folks in charge at the time said, we can't sell the building for $1. It's worth more than $1. So.
That's
happens all the time now.
Yeah.
Right. Oh yeah.
They hooked up school and something like
that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Exactly.
$100.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they have a great deal.
Yeah. So we are having a public hearing in the end of July
31st.
31st.
Yeah.
So to Bob has got he's going to contact his two people that quoted the job and have them do the other revision with them, and then we'll bring it to the town. On the 31st,
see
what the feeling is. So at this point, I will get clarification since Susanna is the one that did this. What her intention was, to me, it was the intention to build a new facility. So and if that is the case, then it needs to be doubled.
That's double us.
Yeah. pretty much, yeah. Well, only for, it's double for the police station only.
But even if it's dream crazy, it's got to be on here, it's got to be accurate. I mean, it may be pie in the sky, it may be 2030, but it's got to be on here, it's got to be the right number, and then we can just decide time frame.
Well, they're hoping that it goes forward, it will go for next year, right?
Well, it's worth it, yeah.
Yeah.
Because at some point, you're going to have to make, you're going to have to decide to make the big expensive repairs here, or just say the heck with it, and let's get the hell out of here.
Yep, so that's what.
And, you know, we've already spent over $1 million in this building since, for the renovation itself, and then the tens of thousands we spent to repair the roofs, the siding, and we still don't have insulation, we still don't have proper windows. You know, we still have water infiltration downstairs, our floors are beginning to rise again. So, you know, I think to fix this building again properly, you're talking at least well over probably $1.5 million to do it properly.
But we've done that room many times before.
Exactly.
If you count the cost, you know, the cost of, we spent some ridiculous big money.
Yep.
Because it's like, you know, yeah.
Well, and the efficiency, I mean, all of your heat is going out the doors, but none of these windows are closed properly or have any kind of an insulation on them. You got rain coming in every time it pours over there in the hallway. I mean, it just needs to.
But you can build a more efficient building than you can ever renovate an old building to be.
Absolutely.
For less money.
Absolutely.
It's new construction. I mean, they know what they're doing.
And the goal is to have it on Silver Street.
Right.
So we already own that. So that's.
And the location is better.
Right.
It's more centrally located for the entire
town. The town's kind of sprawled a little. Plenty to say we're all the sprawl, but this ain't really the best location.
Yeah.
No, you know, 100 years ago it was when the people walked to the town hall and they walked to the police department and their business.
So, you know, it doesn't put a price tag on the land that you would have to buy. So that helps. So anyway, okay, so I will get clarification on that, Bob. So your priorities are, ones and ones and ones, right? You want to have everything. I didn't mean that sarcastically, but you know, but your priority, your vehicles are always yearly or every other year.
Correct.
Right, so.
But this is something we've seen every year. I mean, this
right.
has been pretty cloppy here. The upswing this time is hearing about this lease situation, because that's kind of, and it's also sort of a 19 thing. I'm using it here over an hour, 2 years up, but it's going to be up.
All right, so, okay, so that wraps up police and now fire.
Okay. Well, this is our kind of our new priorities now. We're going to kind of like reprogram ours.
Okay.
Obviously, the first one, fire engine, I'll be lying through that. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Sorry. Of course, the fire engine one. Very well, serving our needs, and a huge upgrade for the whole community. Everybody here, from all those of us that support it, should be very proud of that piece, because we are the fire department. So.
Whatever happened, to refresh my memory, what actually happened to the remaining the old truck? What happened was someone stripped out or repurposed?
The truck basically was taken to the junkyard and demolished.
Really?
We stripped everything off of that we could. An awful lot of the stuff from that truck we utilized. We took all the lighting off of that truck to the tune of at least $10,000, and all that has been installed on engine one. The total upgrade of engine one's lighting package as far as emergency response goes. So we saved all of that stuff. We took the truck and we have that either available to us if we can down the road have that installed into engine one. So we've taken stuff from what was that, and we've been able to redistribute it amongst some of the equipment within the department to upgrade. Because of the grant money, basically they got $109,000 for the truck, so we stripped everything that we could that was serviceable, and then it had to be destroyed.
Well, the last major upgrade was cosmetic on that vehicle, so a lot of things that you took off, the peripheral things,
were
all upgraded.
Are still good, and that's why we
upgrade the pump, the motor,
that was
the chassis, and the drive.
Yeah, when you turn it upside down, you still had a 30-year-old truck, and it just wouldn't serve the purpose anymore. So that's where that went. But of course, we can take that one right off the list. And I'll look it down here as we prioritize these, and you look at the new list. A lot of the items have not changed. It's just that we need to change the order in which we need to apply to. sooner than later. And the issue is that most of those portable radios that we have now are $5,000 to $6,000 now piece.
So.
And we need to have 20 now.
So instead of 60, we need to bring it up to 65.
Right.
Okay.
Right, and the thing was, is I was also looking down here, let me just hold on a second with that. And then the next one that we flopped into the number two spot is to replace the forestry. The truck that we have now is 2003, and that was not so much purchased or designed by the fire department. It was given to us through some means that was arranged years ago. And again, it's an 03, so it's better than 15 years old. It just barely meets our needs, but the other reason why it needs to be upgraded is the state as a whole and the Seacoast Chiefs Association has a new program which has got to initiate. And instead of using individual units to get called to emergencies, they're going to start using a strike team type of philosophy. And what that is there will be five units of like equipment, whether it be a tanker, an engine, or a forestry, that would get sent to these incidents. The fire in Barrington last week, that went to four alarms. They needed water tenders or tankers sent to that scene. So they do what they call now, instead of taking the ones that are really local, they're going to step it out and go to other communities, and they do a task force type of thing. And that's how the forestry thing is running. There's been more and more large forest fires, if you want to say that, whether it be in the White Mountains or Lincoln or Alton or wherever. It seems to be happening more in this state on an annual basis, and we're right on the cusp of that now because we're in the extremely dry category again for the state. We are in these strike teams between our engines, our tanker, and our forestry. And in order to meet the needs of the forestry, it has to have four people on board. The forestry had not only carried two. So that's one of the reasons why this command vehicle is an asset, because if this gets called to go to Alton, as an example, for a fire, the forestry can go with two people, the car will augment it, and be able to fill out with the four people we have to have. But down the road, that may not be the best way to do it. We should have four guys on that one vehicle and go, so we don't have to use two vehicles to do what the work of one should be. Okay, so that's why those two had changed.
Okay.
And then the filling station in the parking lot and whatnot just kind of filled in behind it. But if I look over here at the CIP and it says what's available funds, is this is, and it says under the filling station, is that correct? If I assume that it says it's $40,000 sitting there.
I'm sorry?
Or am I wrong?
What was your question?
Under CIP reserve fund, if you come down.
You have 40 in your air pack.
Yeah, filling station.
That's in the CIP.
I get it. And the way I'm reprioritizing this, if that money's sitting there, I would see where that would be a bigger asset if we put it towards our portable radios.
It can be moved. But it also can be moved to other departments who might have more needs. Okay, I'm just saying.
I know that's how this is. We're all here to deal
this
with that.
This is like negotiable. This is where the intent was, but it can be moved and the needs arise.
I understand, because there's always that kind of fluctuation.
Now, does that cause you some concern? Because I know in the past you've spoken that in the air filling station, we go to another place to have them filled.
We do.
We pay for that.
We do.
And I know this was a real value to have, but for life safety purposes, we really should have that in our building.
Correct.
For life safety, I wouldn't quite put it in that term. What it would allow us to do is increase a lot of the in-house training we do. We don't do a lot of that because if we go and do some training, we use 10 or 12 bottles in an evening's practice. Then we have to take another hour or two to go get them filled up in another community. And they're not always available to do it because it's Summersworth. And Summersworth is getting busier and busier and busier. We've called over their time and said, we've got a dozen bottles we need to have filled. Sorry, can't do them.
Either that or bring them up and we'll take care of them.
Yeah, and they just sit there until whenever that happens.
So the benefit we have of this tank here, you'd be able to replenish and do more training. But when all the bottles are filled, as they sit in the house, ready to go, you know, if there is a call, even if we have the station in the house, those are the bottles you're going to be able to use for the fire. And if those run out, but that's not the case because you have a great surplus of available for your staff, I'm sure.
We do. And at any incident you go to, there's going to be an air filling station at that incident. Summersworth will send their air van, and there's three trailers, which are, one is housed in Lee, one is in Rye, and one is in Rochester, along with Seacoast Chiefs, and you can call them to an emergency, and they're right there. So basically the responsibility this incident someplace like we were in Barrington and we were using air, before we leave and get demoed from the incident, we make sure that our bottles are 100% full before we go, because that unit is on site. This is something that the air filling station is something, yes, we should have, because it would make our job easier. We wouldn't have to rely on other people. That's kind of always what I've said. We should be able to be self-sufficient with this. As of now, that's one of those things we talk about in flux and money's in flux. That's what that is, because right now you talk life safety, those portable radios are much more important.
And I understand that, but are we not on target with our training of our new people?
Oh, no, we are.
Okay, so we are. So we're not jeopardizing anyone by not educating them as to how things work.
We should be with that. Of course, it might be more. But there's certain
more is always better.
More is always better. Yeah, exactly right. And so, you know, we prioritize as to what type of training we're going to do. We still do the training, but maybe we just won't have breathing up air the whole time. They'll still do a search drill or a rescue recovery drill or whatever, but they just may not be up the air. So we play on both sides of that.
So it's a convenience factor. Pushing that back, it would be convenient. There's a value to it, but you're not overly concerned by pushing that back and putting more.
Not at this instance. Not when I have portable radios that start to fail. I have no option to replace it, and as they fail,
right,
we have less. I mean, that's our biggest issue.
That's what we want, is priority. I mean, I know the parking lot will probably continue to get pushed back every year because the town isn't made of money.
I got it.
But I mean, and now that I understand it's a convenience factor, it's definitely a value not to send someone. We're not putting anyone in harm's way and not having enough air to service our people and to properly handle the crisis.
Yep.
We're not that way. So,
no, because
it's not a big deal to push that back at all. We're really
have another option.
That could be pushed back another year. Who knows if something big comes up. All right.
Yeah. Looking down the road even further, other than the radios and the need for the upgrade to the forestry, the fire truck, but that's, you know, that's 10, 12 years down the road. It's just manipulating these needs right here. And that one can continue to rotate around until we get back to the top. But the radio, but the other option we have is also said, Summersworth is a primary one because they are within the mutual aid agreement. They have to pay dues to every year, so that's why we use them. I got a backup to them. And Summersworth isn't available, I can make a phone call to Dover because they now have a filling station at their north end station, which they didn't have until 2 years ago. So if we were totally stuck and really needed to have it done, Summersworth couldn't supply a person, it's a phone call away, and I know they'll be able to do it. So we do have a backup to the backup.
So if you just said something that kind of sparked this, if you're looking for a fire truck in the next, maybe in 12 years, that should be on the okay? Because we need 12 years to pay for it, you know? And it's the lowest priority, but it needs to be on. We should be thinking about between 12 and 20 years, or 15 and 20 years, of what are we actually going to be needing, especially the $400,000 fire trucks, you know? I mean, those really.
By then, you'd probably be talking 800,000.
Exactly. That's my point.
That's,
you know, we're only. And pickup trucks and dump trucks and all of those are way more than a cruiser, but, you know.
The one we just got, roughly, is $500,000 by the time we're done with it.
So
you're talking, you know, another 10 or 12 out, that's going to be $700,000.
Yeah. So if you don't put it on this year, you absolutely should need to put it on next year.
Well, you know,
okay.
I kind of like, I understand, and I know, and I understand that from before, but it's kind of like, hold off on that just a little bit. You just got one. And I know how people's trains of thought can be.
Well,
so I'm kind of like, let's just get the immediate priorities that we need now, and we can throw that in for the next year. Maybe we'll see it start showing up.
Yeah.
You know, in 2030 or whatever, something like that, and we can start planning for that.
Because the Board of Selectmen want to be as proactive as possible,
yep,
especially on the big ticket items. So I encourage you, if not this year, next year. Now, you kind of addressed the paving stabilized front ramp.
Nope, I have not.
Are you taking it out? Having prior.
We're in discussion with that.
We
have,
between myself and George, we've kind of started a plan on that.
About it.
To where it does not have to be entered onto this.
Okay.
Between what he can do and some of what I can do out of the building maintenance funding,
okay,
we can get the area in front of where the fire trucks are. we're starting to make a plan to take care of that without having to go through this process.
Works for me.
With the funding that we already have available to us.
Alright, okay. Anything else?
Thank you.
Alright, so if I understand it, your portable radios are your priority, then your forestry pickup, and then your filling station, and then down below, it's just kinda what it is.
Just what it is.
Oh, okay.
But you're also still talking, because I would say if he is the purchase target here, you're talking, yes to the, I mean, I know the CIP is designed to be like a 10-year plan, but it sounds to me like the portable radios thing is a now thing.
Well, again.
Well, they've been on there.
Some of the discussion we were having amongst the select board is also the fact that, I mean, that's a large number right now, but the thing was, we were talking again, doing your operation within the department's budget, and just budget for, you know, $30,000 in there a year within the operational budget. Buy a group every year for the next 3 or 4 years, then we'd be caught up to where we needed to be. So it could go either way, and that's a discussion that's important, so I don't know if we need to have.
Yeah, because they're just all failing.
They're starting to fail, yeah.
You know, involved.
And we can't do it, yeah, at least start that process, so we can at least have 5 new ones in our hands. So if we start having the other ones fail, at least I know I got 5 of them, but I can feel pretty confident that we'll not have an issue.
Yeah, so, you know, we can also do a half budget, half CIP too, you know, so there's ways that we can work around that to get you at least reliable ones.
Start the process.
For the next year.
So we have it in here, and then we'll, you know, further discussion on the other options.
Yep, exactly. Okay, anything else? Alright, George?
The GMC.
What do you want?
Put off of last year. And it's in there for $190,000. We can reduce that to about $160,000. I've already seen the truck already built. That would serve our needs much better than spending the money on a big full-size dump truck, because the roads in town are not nowhere near as big as most towns.
And you still have this as a 2019 purchase?
It depends. It's what you guys wanna do. We need a sidewalk, we need our sidewalks.
Need a what?
Sidewalk machine that will fit our sidewalks.
Sidewalk machine, what does that mean? Like a plow?
Snowplow.
Snowplow, okay.
That would fit our needs, fit our sidewalks, so we can open the sidewalks like we should be opening them instead of half. I got a quote for a machine for about, it's actually a little loader, so it's a year-round use, it's not just for sidewalks. It's, this is the sidewalk specific, it's not sidewalk specific. It's a little, would replace the skids, not replace the skids, the skids would be transferred to transfer station account. So we can put that, move that off the CIP and put it under transfer station. This can see it later on down the road. That, you can have a sander on it, so we can sand our sidewalks, but you can't do the skid steer we have. And that goes down to as narrow as 4 feet, so it'll fit 99% of the sidewalks we have in town. And we should be opening every sidewalk that's available and maintain them with the sand spreader and all that. It's also articulating bucket loader, so you can use that instead of running around the big backhoe when you've got projects. And let me shut this. So I don't know which way the town wants to go on that. Sidewalks should be maintained, and this is falling off. The one we have is 5.5 feet wide. The sidewalks are 5 feet. You're falling off the sidewalk half the time when you're doing them, and you're digging up lawns and stuff when you're doing shop deals, etc. That you can have a snow mower on. A mower will fit on that.
The roadside mower?
Yep. And visibility is 100% better. City Somerville Housing Authority has one of their machines, and I used it in Berwick when I was broke down last year. And the utilization of that machine for what we need is far superior than having a skid steer unit.
But the utilization comes when you buy more attachments.
That's all part of the price.
There's different, you know, buck buckets, there's forks, there's grapplers, there's mowers, there's shears.
Anything that fits on that skid steer will fit on that machine.
And do we have this equipment already?
We have a sweeper, we have a set of forks, we have a roadside mower.
And it'll fit on this one?
It'll fit on the machine. That heavy attachment of Bobcat, the skid steer, will fit on that machine.
And when we get that guaranteed, then we wouldn't get it here and find out it didn't.
It's the same attachment plate and everything on the front of that. High flow, everything. The quote is for, and of course the quote's expired, I just got this. This is good until $71,000, but you're looking at $80,000 by thinking the same and everything. So that's just something I just thought we'd throw out there and.
So is this replacing something on here? What's the Bob?
Now, Bobcat is the skid, what we have now for someone.
Okay, so why do I need another one?
Because that machine is too wide for most of our sidewalks.
But if you got that?
We could leave that at the transfer station. You own the machine, you already own the machine.
Okay.
You're not replacing it. I mean, we're not gonna look at replacing that. That can go, later on down the road when the machine dies, let's take it right off the list.
But this is to buy a new one.
Not 19 though.
Not 19, that's a few years out.
Right, but do we need that if we have that?
But you can extend the life of all of these. If this is taking a load off the backhoe, off the Bobcat.
That's right, you're not running the motor.
So this might, that Bobcat might gain 2 years of life.
So you still need a Bobcat.
You should have it at the transfer station. You can leave it over to the transfer station. That's why I would suggest putting it in the transfer station account. Take it off the highway department side of it.
I'll put it down here.
But there's no denying that we would use a new machine to save, just like you said, you'd be buying time on the older machines.
Absolutely, without a doubt.
So there's a value to that to offset that $71,000, I guess you could look at. And we don't have to go, I mean, because I know the attachments take it big, they get expensive fast. We have it all.
We have
everything to do reasonably.
The only thing
that
we're going to need on that particular machine, you're going to need a new snow load. When it fits.
Of course.
Then you need the sander attachment. But the rest of it, all the skid steer attachment we have, the forks, and even the wider bucket we could use. Mm-hmm. But this machine comes with its own, all its own equipment. But
what's the bucket a blower set of cost for the new machine?
That price is all with the machine. On the machine.
Blower included, snow blower, the sander is all included in that?
No, that's why I brought that up to 80, but this is...
Okay.
The machine itself...
Well, we're not buying any new equipment for equipment we already own, because we can reuse it.
Right. Oh, the snow blower and everything is in this price.
I didn't know that. Okay, that's good.
Snow blower...
But we're not buying anything that we currently have for our other Bobcat.
And even the sander squirt is on there. So it won't be
There'll be no additional subsequent purchases the next year to get equipment.
No, nope, shouldn't have to. Okay.
Okay, so what are you calling that?
It's actually called a Wackenusen. The machine is made by Wackenusen. That's the name of the company. It's a tall articulating loader. How's that?
That's an awful lot of words.
Side machine, sidewalk machine.
New toy.
I mean, you could, a sidewalk specific machine is $150,000. I don't even want to make
up that. What do you think you might, how would that adjust out your target purchase year on the Bobcat? I mean, from 2021.
I don't think we'll have to replace the Bobcat.
Because it's like.
Keep it, we own it, let's wait till it dies.
And give it
so we can give it a longer life.
Yeah.
Under the transfer station.
Yeah.
That's
all we're going to use it for. So actually, it should be presented though that's also $20,000 you're not going to have to spend in the future. So that kind of reduces that by $20,000, so 50, 60.
Okay. So
I'm reducing the price of the dump truck by about $30,000 this year if we keep that in the CIP.
And you see
the
truck, that's a real number.
A truck completely built, we was just at the show up in Mount Centipede. The truck they had completely built, dumped body, side dumped, sanded, built on the truck, not having a sliding sander, just built.
Exactly what you would want, exactly what
correct.
You would get.
The way I run it was $150,000. So you're going to look, I'm looking at a year newer, you know, $10,000.
And we're still looking at that as a 2019 purchase.
My preference would be the sidewalk machine. And we could put this out 1 more year. We put this out from last year.
You could.
The truck is still usable.
Well, that's just food for thought.
You're confusing me. Hold on 1 second. I thought you said the 160 was for the GMC Top Kick.
Right.
Okay, but then you just mentioned the dump truck, which is...
That's the same truck.
Why is that on your place?
The dump truck, the internet, that's two dump trucks we have.
I'm sorry?
The 74 International is in 2025.
Right.
That's not even being touched.
Oh, so that's not changing to 160. We're only talking about the Top Kick.
The Top Kick is
right.
The one that's
you said dump truck, you can choose.
But there's a possibility of a bot picking it up 1 year. Possibility, which is bad stuff around it for the purpose of the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
But you really stress the earth, you really see the value in getting the new piece.
The truck is underpowered. We made it through the winter last year. The truck is not in the worst condition in the world. I mean, I'm not saying that the motor couldn't go in here. But that truck is still, you know, usable. I could get another year out of that truck easily, I believe. So we can push that one out.
And it's just do normal use. It's not, it wasn't
all
a poor
purchase. All we use that truck for is, right now, is plowing and sanding.
But that wasn't a poor purchase back in 17. That was a good truck. I mean, we bought what we needed, right? We didn't underspend
that truck,
something.
That particular Top Kick truck,
yeah, 10 years
was
later.
Overbuilt.
It's overbuilt.
It's a smaller
okay, so
truck, and they built it to make it work like a big truck.
And that's what happened when you overwork a
and
truck.
And they wanted to keep
yeah.
it in under the. They built that truck to fit under the commercial license.
That's
you didn't need to have a commercial license to drive it. They put big truck tires on it, which lowered the power.
Sure.
They got a big wing on it, and a big plow. That's making that truck work much harder than it should be working. And it reduced the life of that truck considerably. That was on last year's plan, and I pushed it 1 year because I wanted to see how it worked. We
and hypothetically, the 150-60 truck you're looking at is the right truck for the right for this
it's
truck.
Not as big a truck. It's not pushing that bigger plow. It's got the sander built in it. You're not carrying a sander inside the truck to add weight. So, what happens, the truck I'm looking at is a side dump, so the sand is coming ahead of the wheels, so we have control of the vehicle a lot better also.
Okay. Alright. So, then your International dump truck is going to stay at 190?
Yeah, by then it's going to be higher than that, so I don't know what the prices are. I know they bought one in Berwick last year, 10-wheeler for $200,000. So we can probably, the 190 is probably stay for a few more years, because it's only a 6-wheel dump truck. But that truck is, there's plenty of life left in it.
Okay.
And you're not accelerating any of the other things that you have down lower on your list?
The heating system we moved last year, they wanted to replace it last year because they said it was inadequate.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a sauna in there. And they found the thing that was plugged up.
Yeah, I heard that.
So that's, I want to replace the boiler in 9 years in my house. So we're good to leave that way out.
Okay.
The backhoe, I'd leave it for 2027, maybe.
Okay.
But then again, we've got to factor in when we're getting this new piece, too, because that's also going to affect backhoe.
Right.
Absolutely.
Roof?
So I'd leave that, the roof, 2024, maybe, by then, we might need a roof. But,
okay.
I mean, right now, you get a piece that flies off occasionally, that's fixable.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, priority, let's just give me numbers for items. What's your priorities?
Priority for me would be the sidewalk machine, about
$80,000. $80,000, that's number one. Okay.
And then the Top Kick, I think we could do that for around $160 to be safe.
And priority?
Two.
But also it may be a 2020.
Yep.
Bobcat going down to transfer station.
And I wouldn't even put that in the replacement for now,
right.
Because it's going to be replaced with this
three, right? Dump truck three?
Yeah, way down.
Okay.
Yep, I leave that on as the way it is, don't change.
Everything, okay, so, alright, so.
Yeah, I don't see any other major purchases.
Alright, and that's all you?
Right now is.
Okay, so, want to talk about transfer as well?
Replace the MSW compactor, that is nothing to be changed there, I don't think. I would just move.
The Bobcat down.
Yeah, and I don't think I'd put a replacement on it right now.
Okay.
That's something in the future, if we decide we need one over there more than what we have, but it's not good to run that thing over the road either, when you're using it. It's a skid steer, it's not a, this machine articulates, you're not dragging tires, you can do 20 miles an hour with this over the road.
There's nothing that this machine can't do that we used to perform that same task with our Bobcat, right? We're not sacrificing anything on our Bobcat. Okay, and what's the lead time on getting a piece of equipment? Do they have it on the ground?
Yep.
No, so there's no ordering and being built?
Nope. I was actually thinking of leasing one that's, see if we could lease one through the winter, to see if we wanted it. If we had extra money hanging out, could rent one, see if that's what they wanna do. And see how it would perform for us this winter, if that's what they wanted to do. This one here is the bar.
Yeah, at least that short-term lease you probably.
It'd be a rental thing, it would be, you're probably looking at a couple thousand a month.
Rental and give it back, yeah.
But they do lease purchases. The housing authority leased it for 3 years and they won. So. Or 2 years or whatever the program was. There's different programs. But not to have a guarantee to purchase that. They didn't, we could rent one from them, but you're not guaranteed you're gonna have all the implements that you want when you're renting it. They'll put a snow blower on it and stuff like that, but maybe they don't want to put a sander on it because they gotta rent it to somebody else later on. That was just another thought. But I think we need something to take care of our sidewalks because people walk on the sidewalks and stone.
And the kids know.
And we can't sand them properly, but we'd have to sand it by hand. We try to run the dump truck as close to the sidewalk as we can and spread the sand, but you're wasting a lot. This would be a drop sander in the sidewalk.
Well, there's narrow little streets in here. God forbid, no one's ever fell underneath a car or got hit by a car because he couldn't walk on the sidewalk. But realistically, we should take care of our people.
Mm-hmm. Take care of them. It's kids walk to school. That sidewalk over there is a tough sidewalk because you're falling off it all the time. The way the curtains and stuff are. The machine's 5.5 feet wide, but if I use a snow bucket, it's 6 feet wide. The sidewalks are 5 or less. If you standardize the sidewalks, which I know there's a plan for sidewalks down the road, but it's right now you still need a machine. I went with this machine because it goes down to 4 feet, so you got your narrow sidewalks. If you have to make 2 passes, you open it up a little bit, but it's a lot easier than trying to do more than what you should be doing.
Okay. So, any other questions for any of the department heads? Any other comments or pleas?
Well, generally, let's have another meeting CIP, but
we probably will, but we're pretty good about, by joining it in one meeting today, we know what they want. This is going to go through the select board. I'm going to revise this, and we will talk about it when Suzanne comes back at the next select board's meeting. I do think we should have one more meeting, at least.
Making
sure that,
information,
Caroline is here and also Bill
Ray. I mean, I can get some more solid numbers on that dump truck before the end. What we want. If that's something they want me to do, I can do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, on the lease option, I'm sure you'll communicate that with us.
Yeah.
It's not that we're signing this in October, but we get some time here.
It's a start.
Do you know how many it is?
It's a no-brainer.
Do I know how many what?
Do you know how many approximately that would be?
Ten.
And how many do you need total?
25.
Okay.
radios.
We have one for each position that somebody could be assigned to.
Okay.
And I can get this upgraded if they've changed, but I don't.
Well, for purposes of CIP, it doesn't have to be, I mean, you know, this is.
Right.
It's more than the decade span, but every time we come, it's always next year.
I mean, yeah, I mean, you're not buying nothing until next year, so you don't, they can't proceed with it.
Well, that's just life, I mean, that's.
No, you have to start with another and then, so.
I mean, some of these trucks are available because they go to stock. And it's, they go to stock pretty much what we're looking for, but not, I'm not looking for something elaborate, I'm looking for a piece of equipment that's gonna do the job.
Yeah, I don't wanna under purchase, which is what happens.
No, I don't wanna build a truck.
And you've got a forestry vehicle as a two seater, I mean, you know, that's not the right vehicle for the job.
Right.
Day one, you know?
No, but I'm talking about, I would not buy the dump truck, you know, I mean, I don't need to have all air control, you know, and all the fancy stuff in it. But we can, you know.
Radio would be nice.
We're getting it.
Yeah.
Flushing the light on top of it.
We gotta have some lights too, but that's.
All right, any other questions or comments for any departments?
Where do you want to go with that?
The stuff like.
Amazon.com.
I think if you want, you can serve a purpose or something like that.
Oh, I'm sure we can.
This car, yeah.
Yes. Yep. I'll get this revised and I'll send everyone a copy so we can see it. And of course, the board will be talking about it. Because as you all know, we have to do budgets much quicker this year because of SE2, so we're gonna be starting much earlier. In our stuff to get it going.
Okay.
Thank you for your time, Emily.
Thank you very much, I appreciate it, we have this going quickly.
Just let you know, I have spoken with both vendors, and I actually met with one of them today.
Okay.
And not gonna be an issue, getting those figures. Not, we're not gonna have complete drawings like we did for the first floor, but the best part of it is, how about just a nice figure so we can present to the public?
We're talking about the same floor plan as below on top, pretty much, right? So that's good. And they can make the public hearing, both of them, the presentation? Good.
And actually, because you've already got the mechanics already built in downstairs, the square foot is actually less upstairs than it is for our floor, so.
And we're gonna have an elevator.
Yeah, we have an elevator.
When is the public hearing gonna be?
July 31st.
That's already established.
Yeah, it hasn't been put out yet, but, you know.
No, but that's the timing purpose.
That is timing purpose.